Well, I would rate the Modi government to have performed very well for very important reasons. One, our GDP has grown by 76 lakh crores from the time he came to power till 2019 March, if you look at estimates, and that is very large. The inflation during this period has been only 4-4.5%. The last UPA government grew the GDP by 56 lakh crores at market value, and the average inflation was 10%. Sure. So GDP has been higher, inflation has been lower. That means our savings have been protected. If I put money into a bank deposits and earn 7% and inflation is 4.5%, I earn 2.5%. Yes. If I put money into a bank deposit, I get 8-8.5%, inflation 9%, I lose my money. So in the UPA 2 era, all of us lost our money. Savings are lost. The middle class has been devastated. The poorer class have been devastated. So on top of it, the economic performance has been very good. Second, the Modi government has spent much, much more on infrastructure than the previous two UPA governments. Mm-hmm. What they have spent in the last, in the 5 years that they've been there, I think is almost equal to, to what the UPA has spent over the last 10 years. We have seen many more roads, many more bridges. The Northeast has developed. The railways infrastructure has gone up very largely. I think the railways are spending something like about 6.5-7 lakh crores for the last 5 years. And they've been rejuvenated. There are no unmanned railway lines anymore, because railway crossings anymore. And we have seen the airports work at peak capacity. Airport traffic has grown in double digits for the last 5 years. We've seen the Ganga getting cleaned, we've seen the ports grow up. In all facets of our infrastructure, I think it's done very well. The third, there has been no corruption in Delhi that we know. The Rafale thing is totally bogus. There is no 30,000 crores that Narendra Modi can take and give it to anybody. Just the other day, Rahul Gandhi said that he's taken the money from the people of Andhra Pradesh. Mm-hmm. I'm sure Babu will be surprised that where was the money that he couldn't take for his own people that Modi took to give it to from the people of Andhra Pradesh. It's a joke. And they're lying through their teeth, and I don't think the people of this country are asserting this teeth. So I think on all economic indicators, jobs, I think totally about 3.5 crores to 4.5 crores jobs have been created. In transportation sector, based on data, 1.5 crores have been created. In the professional sector, based on data, about 40 lakhs have been created. And in the EPFO data and the ESI, another about 1.5-2 crores jobs have been created. And if you look at government jobs, about 35-40 lakh jobs have been created. So maybe 3.5-4 crores have been created. And these are all verifiable data. The NSSO survey is very wrong. I think I don't know whether they ask the right kind of questions. Unemployment has not increased massively in the last 5 years. People in the working age group coming down, is not correct. We need to understand what questions to ask, how the data is. I hope the government releases all this. So on the jobs front too is there. And lastly, on the global scale, I remember going outside India in 2013-14, there's no respect for India. Mm-hmm. Now there's respect for India. I go to Japan very much, they respect India. I go to the US, they respect India. I go to the UK, they respect India. I go to Europe, they respect India. All around the world, there's much more respect for India than there was earlier. And India is recognized as the fastest growing economy. India is recognized as something that stands for, that stands for the future. So I think respect for India all over has improved. So I think the work has, very good work has been done in the last 5 years.